Hi, this is Alex from TKO Fitness. We're gonna start with 5 minutes of jumping rope. Every time you make a mistake, you gotta do a burpee. So let's go. You know, I have a jump rope jumping jacks. About every 30 seconds, you'll do a burpee anyhow. Gotta beat me. So far, I'm at 2. Still at 4. Still at 4. That noise is my brother. We're not open for business. Nobody's hitting the bags. It's just my brother. You're doing better than me. Good on you. 5 mistakes. Not too hot. Definitely over halfway home. Six. Your toes, huh? That's 8. Got about a minute change to go. Nine. Great job. So if you have boxing gloves or 1 pound weights or whatever, you can use them. Just put something in your hands. Keep yourself moving. I'll give you some basic drills. I'm gonna do everything right-handed. We're gonna start with basic 1-1-2. Let me just go over everything. So 1 is your left jab, going straight right out, bring it right in. 2 is your straight right hand. 3 will be your left hook. 4 is your right hook. 5 is your left uppercut. And 6 is your right uppercut. So what you're gonna do is we're gonna start with 1-1-2. You're going to step on your jab, and punch. Again, 1-1-2. Take your time. I know you can't really see my feet too crazy, but this is the motion right here. You're going step and punch, 5, okay? 1-1-2, again, 1-1-2. And you always wanna be on the balls with your feet. You're gonna keep repeating that. Give it a good minute and a half. Just keep doing the same thing over and over again. Don't just go crazy, especially when you're shadow boxing. You're fighting no one. Take your time, all right? You got 5 minutes of shadow boxing, all right? In between and all of this, right around the 2-2.5 minute mark, I'm looking for 5 lunges, 5 squats. Real simple. Keep your weights in your hands. Step out, lunge, bring it back. That's 1, all right? A squat right here. Sit back, squat down, drive up, all right? At the end of your 5 minutes, you wanna fire 100 straight shots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 50 each arm. Then you wanna, if you have a heavy bag, you wanna wrap up and hit the heavy bag. We got 3 rounds, all right? And I'll show you some combinations on that. If you don't have the heavy bag, that's perfectly, perfectly fine. What I want you to do is I want you to grab your jump rope again. 5 more minutes of the jump rope with the burpee penalty. 5 more minutes of shadow boxing, nice and slow, all right? If you have a heavy bag or something that you're able to hit, then you can do the bag work, all right? What I'm looking for with regard to heavy bag work, you're gonna set a timer, 3 rounds, all right? 3 minutes each round with a 30-second break in between. And I want you to practice the exact 3 combinations that I'm gonna give you today. That's it. Repetition is the key to success. The only way you're going to get better at this stuff is by actually doing it over and over and over, and then over and over and over some more, all right? So we're gonna start with a base 1-1-2. That'll be your first combination. What I'm looking for is you're going to fully extend. 1-1-2. Take your time, drive with your straight right hand, all right? That 2, twist your hip and drive it through. That way you've got some leverage on it. 1 more time, 1-1-2. That's it. I want you to fully extend from your target and be able to back to hit it, maximum range, all right? Another combination was 1-2-3. So you're gonna give me 1-1-2 for 1 full round. Then we'll move on to 1-2-3, which is jab cross hook. 1-2-3. Take your time again. 1-2-3. Now, I don't want you stepping and ending up on top of the bag the entire time. No one is going to hit you. You need to back up and fully extend. Back up, fully extend. 1-2-3. You're gonna take a baby step, that's fine. Just don't end up smothering the bag. All right, your last combination is gonna be 1-2, 1-2, 3-2. Jab, cross, hook, cross. If you really wanna get into it, you're going to be driving every other punch, all right? Because 1-2, 1-2, 3-2 says so. Take your time. 1-2, 1-2, 3-2. One of my old trainers, Aaron Ford. Shout out Aaron. Used to teach me about the machine washer, all right? And you wanna start getting your hips involved with all of your shots. Your 2s and your 3s. Your 2s and your 3s. And this combination is perfect for that, all right? So 1-2, 1-2, 3-2. Take your time. Those are your 3 combinations for this class, all right? So 1-1-2 for 1 round. 1-2-3 for the 2nd round. And then 1-2, 1-2, 3-2. With an emphasis on your hips, making sure you're moving your leg for the 3rd round. Remember, it's 3 rounds, 3 minutes each round, 30-second break in between. Do work. So one of the first core exercises that I like to do is seated exchanges. I have medicine ball readily available to me. If you don't, that's fine. Grab a dumbbell, grab a free weight, grab a can of tomato pasta, a paste or something. I don't know, okay? Grab something from the kitchen, all right? What I want you to do is take a seat,
Legs will be elevated side to side. Do not bounce the ball on the ground. You're gonna go for about 30 seconds at a time, all right? 30 seconds on, and then you'll go into a 30 second static hold right here. All right, if you're looking for more exercise, you can drive it up, you can drive the weight in front of you. All right, keeping your legs off the ground the entire time is the most important thing because you're engaging your core, all right? 30 seconds on, 30 seconds off, then you'll take a 30 second break. I want you to repeat that three times. 30 on, 30 off, 30 rest. On, off, rest, all right? And by on, off, again, legs are up the entire time for 1 minute. Engage your core for 3 minutes straight, all right?
Another good at-home exercise to do, resistance band curls. In the event that you don't have resistance bands, by all means, again, any kind of at-home weights work, the concept will remain the same. You'll still get the same benefits from it. What I want you to do is I want you to step on the resistance band. Now, the wider that it is, the easier the exercise is, okay? So the wider my feet are on the band, the easier the exercise is. The closer together that they are, the harder it is, all right? It provides more resistance. I want you to take your time, and I'm looking for sets of 15, all right? Three sets of 15, so boom, and down, and right back up. Take your time, three sets of 15, five push-ups in between. Let's fry those arms a little bit. Another leg exercise that I really like to do, left lunge, right lunge, squat. I've got 25 pounds that I'm holding on to. You can use whatever household weight you've got. You can use a small infant, toddler, whatever. Use your 7-year-old, make it work, all right? Left lunge, right lunge, bring your feet in squat position, sit back, squat. Do that again. Left lunge, right lunge, and squat. You wanna take your time and you wanna go through three sets of 15. 15 is the optimal number. Do what you can, not what you can't, but I want three sets though. A tremendous core exercise that I always like to do are transition planks, all right? I'm gonna demonstrate the actual motions. The time is 30 seconds, 60 seconds, and 30. 30 on side, 60 in the middle, 30 on the side. I'll demonstrate. So, side plank position is as follows here. Stack your legs, hips up, drive that shoulder back. I'm here for 30 seconds, all right? Once your timer goes off, you transition to the middle for 60 seconds. Notice, my palms are up, my butt is down. Tighten, engage your core. Lastly, you will transition to the other side for another 30 seconds. 30, 60, 30, all right? You will do that three rounds with a 30 second break in between. Three rounds, 30 second break in between. Engage that core. You'll thank me in the summertime. So my old man would always tell me that the triceps were the easiest muscle to develop. Nah, true that, whatever, but all right, dips are a perfect exercise that you can do at home almost anywhere, all right? I'm gonna use this flat bench, but you can use a chair, you can use almost anything. Matter of fact, I'm gonna demonstrate here, I'm gonna demonstrate on something completely different, all right? So right here, you wanna get your hands in nice and close. A good rule of thumb is have your thumbs being able to touch each other, all right? If you're able to do that, great, drop down and bang out as many as you can. A good number, 15, but you know, do what you can, not what you can, all right? Take your time. Awesome. Step, dips. Stop making that noise. Step, dips, get it popping. See, you can do it on almost anything, man. Get your work on.